This lesson is an introduction to GIS import, specifically importing a shapefile. Go to the File menu, open the Import-Export menu, select Import ArcView File. KYPipe 2018 will prompt you to save your current file before running the Import tool. This is because after the Import tool has run, KYPipe 2018 loads the newly imported model, closing your existing model, causing you to lose any unsaved changes. We'll say no, because in this example, there is no existing model. Imported GIS data can vary with regards to connectivity and the number and types of nodes. This import tool is designed to address some of the more common issues. There are tolerance settings, along with buttons that access the help file entry for these settings. Users can select Fix Connectivity Errors and Check for Crisscross Pipes options. Users can also select the Skip Some Intermediate Nodes option, which changes the number of nodes imported. However, we recommend that you initially try to import without these options checked. And then, if you encounter issues, retry the import using some or all of these features. Also, there are other tools that can address connectivity issues after import as opposed to during import. I'll demonstrate that later in this video. In the Import menu, first select the type of model you are building. KYPipe, which is steady state, or extended period simulations, Surge, which is for transients, Gas and Steam, or Stormwater. For this example, we'll use KYPipe. There is also an option to load an existing .p2k file. If you choose this option, you can load that file and then append point data, but not line data. So, continuing with this example, when beginning an import, the first step is to load line data to create your pipes. So we select the appropriate folder where we see the shapefiles to be imported. There is an 8-character import limit for shapefile names, and some of these names exceed that limit. However, the program can work around that. Select any one of the shapefiles you are going to import. We will pick water lines, but this step is only pointing the program at the appropriate folder. A dialog box appears asking if we wish to create a temporary subfolder. Click Yes. Next, we want to find our polylines shapefile. In this example, it's called water lines. Now we want to match up any shapefile attributes that we want imported as KYPipe model attributes. The KYPipe attributes are on the left, and the shapefile attributes are on the right. We'll check the boxes for any data items we wish to match. For example, the shapefile pipe diameter can be matched with the model's pipe diameter. Next, click on Match Selection. As we go through this process, our matched data items will appear in this menu box. If we have a shapefile data item that we want to import that doesn't directly correspond to a model hydraulic or descriptive characteristic, such as roughness or install year, we can match that characteristic with one of the many user data items allowed by the program. So we might match date record with user data item 1, and it will be available in the newly created model. Now we want to process the matched data. So we click the next available menu button on the left-hand side of the import menu, which is Read the Pipe Shapefile. Some of the tool buttons in KYPipe won't return a message or dialog box saying that the action is completed. which is the case here, so we just go to the next available button and click on Process Pipe Data. We have two other shapefiles to import, so next we will select valves from the drop-down list. Sometimes there isn't any meaningful information in the shapefile, so if we don't want to match any data items, we next click on Process Valve Data. Next, we'll import hydrant data, and without anything to match up, we'll just click on Process Hydrant Data. Since there are no other shapefiles to import, we'll click on Save.p2k File. Give it a name, and now KYPipe is generating the model. When that's done, click Exit. If the shapefile is in a known set of coordinates, we can click on Internet Maps, check the box for Show Maps, select the desired map source and type, and then in the Coordinate Name drop-down list, select the coordinate system of our shapefile. When we click on Return to Map, we'll see the map we selected in the background. In the Internet Maps menu, we can import elevations for our model. This is done under the Elevations/Addresses tab. Choose a source for your elevations and click the Update All Elevations button. Now, we'll return to the map area and click on a node where we can see the imported elevation. After importing a shapefile, it's important to do a connectivity check. Click on the Analysis menu button and then click on Connectivity Check. When this dialog box appears, click on any pipe. The blue-colored pipes are connected to the selected pipe, and the red-colored pipes are disconnected. To correct this, we'll go to the Edit menu and use the Connect Crisscross Pipes tool. A dialog box for the tolerance setting appears. The tolerance setting is in feet or meters, depending on what flow units were entered in the System Data menu. Tolerance refers to the distance from the end of a disconnected pipe to the nearest pipe or node within which the pipe will be connected. We'll accept the default. And we see that KYPipe has made the connections.